On the paper, it's not that hard. The elevation, the fact that it's a multi-pitch and waking up early.
The rock looks just gorgeous. It's awesome.
All those little details that make it really hard. So our first try, we got to the first pitch and we're like, no way are we gonna do that today.
Pitumarga is a small town on the south of Cusco. It's a nice small town. For climbers, I think it's perfect.
Back in 2018, we were in Pitumarca developing in the Chaco-Huayasca Valley. And one day with Coco, the local, we decided to drive around to go look at another cliff that we could see from far behind. And we never found the road to go to it, but we ended up going in that other valley and we faced that giant wall that just has to be bolted. Looked like super good limestone. Since then, we really wanted to just come back for it and bolt it and take that challenge because it really looked like the challenge. So over the course of maybe a bit more than a year, we were texting back and forth with Coco. Big goal in that kind of project here is to get the authorization from the communities. Super excited, we got the thumbs up to develop the Achojo Valley.
I think step one was pretty obvious. We needed to find a line.
That's it?
And it's freaking hard to breathe.
What's our altitude?
Over 4,800 right now for sure.
We hiked to the top with my brother. It was a cool ridge traverse to get to the very point of the tower.
Came from the top because it was pretty easy to reach, and the goal was just to wrap down to the bottom to get a sense of how the wall is or where the roots could be. So for this project, we're using some 10 millimeter bolts, but for the anchors, we're getting some 12 millimeters with some nice rings on it. Josh is gonna go for the big plunge. Be safe, don't let the rope go. Well, I'm up here on the wall, probably, I don't know, 30 meters below the top, and Josh is under me, is putting up some just some bolts here and there to redirect us, and the rock looks just gorgeous. It's awesome.
A very nice thing to be efficient in our work and not waste too much time driving around is that we were able to set up camp almost at the base of the wall. So we could finish late and come back to the tent, eat, sleep for 10, 11 hours and wake up early in the morning and start working early and have big days.
Day two was yesterday and we started from the bottom with a static line that we had installed and starting the bolting the first two pitches. It's slower than I thought it would be.
Well, this is our first time bolting a multi-pitch route. Maybe we've bolted like two pitches, but we haven't bolted something that's 240 meters.
Working in high altitudes is different. You can definitely feel it.
Yeah, moving slower, taking your time. So we're just like figuring out the best systems and trying to find the line because this rock is interesting where there's so many features and holds across the big faces where it's just kind of hard to like connect the dots. So you just basically connect the biggest, coolest features together and hopefully we'll have a rad line that makes sense and that climbs nice.
So I'm bolting the third pitch.
So this is the fifth anchor of seven. Oh, I can stand now. Ooh, yeah. I usually have a ratchet for this one, but I don't have it. I gotta go old school. Old school sucks. So the tagline, are you at 30 meters yet?
I think we can put our next anchor on that grassy ledge. That should be about 30 meters.
Super. Ooh. Just taking a little break.
Snowing a little bit.
Bit of snow right now.
One, two, three, four.
Four jackets on.
See my sock style?
Yeah!
Fun fact, but not really. I'm clearing my throat up from yesterday.
Six pitches, each pitch is about 35 meters. We have a tagline measuring the distance, and then we kind of just keep working together.
The final name of that seven pitch route that we bolted, Vuelo del Condor, it felt super appropriate, and especially one day when we were bolting, we had a condor flying literally meters from us, and that was one of the most memorable things that happened on this wall.
Yeah, I think it took us about 4 or 5 days to bolt the whole line.
The route is bolted.
The route is bolted, just need to be climbed.
It was the day right after we finished bolting, we just decided to we're gonna on-site this whole thing.
Rock climbing. Goal of the day is to send the line we bolted.
And yeah, by the time we reached pitch one, we were both at the anchor. We're like, we're not gonna send this thing today. We both already fell on pitch one, and it's like a lot harder than we thought.
Take our time, work each pitch, and come back another day for the sand.
And as we continued up to pitch five, every pitch surprised us with difficulty, and it was humbling experience. We don't have to send it today, it doesn't matter. But it was just like, all right, it's definitely a lot more work. And we were just like cramping up and dehydrated and tired. We were pulling a haul bag. So we were like, all right, next time we do this, we have to, go lighter, find the right pace. And we rested a few days.
Yeah, it was nice. We took a little break for a few days and got to enjoy the area around Pitumarca.
Jan's trying to get a selfie.
Let's see, we went to Rainbow Mountain. Went to Machu Picchu Marca. So it was nice to go to Cusco and get that hot shower and see a different landscapes and scenery and fuel up on different food.
It's 4:15 in the morning and we're drinking some coffee. This is the most clouds we've seen.
It's bloody cold.
And it's bloody cold.
The thing we noticed when trying the route is that every other pitch is a hard pitch, so that not the same person leads all the pitches. We decided to do leader leads two pitches and then the other one leads the next one, etc., etc.
Yeah, we left camp at 6, we got to the wall, 6:15, did some stretching.
Yeah, sure, let's stretch it.
We're gonna go for a solid attempt today.
I might go to the third bolt and lower down, or I might just go for it. And yeah, 8A plus at 6:30 in the morning was, not something I wanted to do, but had to do. And yeah, it's really nice. It's very crimpy. It's 35 meters. It's awkward feet, awkward hands, hard sections.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I like got to the anchor and I was like, holy shit.
Difficulty. Oh man, it feels good to get that one done.
And I know Charlotte's gonna do it, so we're like off to a rad start.
Well, I didn't know I could do it. Because there's that bouldery section in the middle. It was a very, very hard shoulder move. Nice. But yeah, I was inspired by Josh Ascent and I didn't want to fail slash fall.
Yeah, perfect. Nice. You're good. Come on. Nice.
Oh, yes. Off to a good start.
Hell yeah.
So Charlotte got to the anchor of pitch one, took a little bit of water, and then I led pitch two, which is 7B, probably 7B plus. So we got that one out of the way. Charlotte came up.
All right. Super. Nice job.
Started pitch three, which was for us the biggest second challenge because it was that vertical positive slab with super technical small holds, just good enough feet, and we're like, yeah, might as well flash it, send it, or just fail on it because like foot pop or couldn't remember the beta.
Just made it to the third anchor, no fall, which is awesome because there's the second pitch I was quite worried about because it was super technical and like some little cruxes, a lot of the feet, so the feet get pumped.
So I followed pitch three and fell. Well, I rehearsed the sequence, which was, you know, just basically 1 foot move that I forgot. Lowered down to the anchor, touched the anchor and started climbing. Met up with Charlotte at the third. Then Charlotte immediately took off for the fourth pitch, which turned out to be like 2, maybe 3 grades harder.
Oh, me too. For sure. We're laughing because we both think that the fourth pitch is much harder than we thought. And we tried really hard. Good job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that was hard.
And then it was Josh's turn to go on the fifth pitch, which was a beautiful traverse.
Yeah, the end of pitch five was the last hardest pitch. It was like a, I don't know, 25 to 30 meter 8A with a hard boulder beginning. The rock was so rounded and perfect and like slightly juggy, really bad feet. And then it had this rad boulder problem that went up this orange stripe. And finishing that was like, oh man, that's it. Like today has gone so smooth. We only have like one more kind of hard pitch. Charlotte started climbing. I looked off in the distance where we could see these big mountains and it looked kind of dark, a little maybe stormy. So I'm keeping an eye on it as Charlotte's going and the thunder is getting louder. It's getting closer. We need to get to the top of this thing before that storm comes. And it maybe looked like we had 30 minutes. I have no idea, you know. So Charlotte took a quick break and fired this last hard pitch, the 7C. At the same time, Jan, the photographer who's been here with us the whole time, he was coming down and filming. And he's like, yeah, guys, you might want to hurry up. The storm's coming this way. And we're like, ah, okay.
It was almost heartbreaking thinking we went up like more than half the roots and all the hardest pitch and that we might get shut down because of the storm in the last two pitches.
Yeah, pushing hard one day and finishing it was kind of sick.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
Really felt like a big accomplishment. We've been thinking about it for so long.
Yeah, for a year.
Like, oh, very hard day to finally loop the loop. 7 pitches, 230 meters, 8A plus max, 7B plus minimum. Average 35 meters per pitch.
Finally the guys send it so we can make a reggaeton fiesta.
Yeah.
Tonight.
Yeah, reggaeton.
Because if not, it's too serious here. I didn't see the bisou.
Once again, we're super grateful that the locals and the local communities allow us to live those experience and help them develop the area in some ways. And we really hope that it's gonna bring more people, not too many though, because this place is amazing.
Yeah, more people out to experience Peter Marca for sure.